بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we will discuss the anatomy of the posterior abdominal wall and the urinary system. Okay. This is posterior abdominal wall. This is inferior vena cava on the right side, and this is abdominal aorta. The abdominal aorta bifurcate into right and left common iliac. The common iliac divided again into internal iliac and external iliac. Branches from the abdominal aorta. This is the first branch, which is the celiac trunk. It gives three branches: splenic, hepatic, and left gastric. And this is the superior mesenteric artery, and this is inferior mesenteric artery. Posterior abdominal wall. This is the right kidney and left kidney. In this right side, the kidney covered by renal capsule. This is the renal capsule. This is the kidney. Covering the kidney, this is the fibrous capsule of the kidney, and this is fat, and then renal fascia, and another fat from outside, or para renal or paranephric fat. This is the kidney on the right side, and this is the kidney in the left side. The kidney, the hilum of the kidney structure enters the hilum of the kidney. This is the renal vein, and this is from the inferior vena cava, and this is the renal artery, and this is a descent downward from the kidney. This is the ureter. Again, the structure in the kidney, this is in front of the renal vein. We remove this renal vein like this, and this is the renal artery, and this is a ureter. We remove the kidney like this. Muscles present in the posterior abdominal wall. This is the iliac crest. So this is the iliacus muscle. Iliac crest, iliacus muscle. And this is the psoas major, and this is the psoas major, and this part of the psoas minor, psoas major. Above the iliac crest, this is the quadratus lumborum muscle. Also, in this cadaver, we see this is a subcostal nerve, iliohypogastric and ilioinguinal, and this is very clear between psoas and iliacus femoral nerve. Medial to the psoas, this is medial to the psoas, this is obturator nerve. Again, muscle in the posterior abdominal wall, psoas major, iliacus, quadratus lumborum. Cadaver showing the posterior abdominal wall. Okay. Again, this is in the right side, this is inferior vena cava. This is abdominal aorta. Aorta again divided into right common iliac and left common iliac. Also, inferior vena cava divided into two common iliac. From the abdominal aorta in this cadaver, this is branches from in front of the abdominal aorta. This is the celiac trunk. Gives us three branches. This is the splenic artery, tortuous artery, and this is the hepatic hepatic on the right side, and this is the left gastric. Again, three branches of the celiac trunk: splenic, left gastric, and hepatic. This is the celiac trunk. Below the celiac trunk, this is the superior mesenteric artery. Superior mesenteric artery. We descend like this. This is the inferior mesenteric artery, just above the bifurcation of the abdominal aorta. Again, also this is the kidney in this side, and this is the renal vein, and this is the renal artery, and descend downward, this is the ureter. In this cadaver, we see also this is the gonadal arteries and vein. This is the gonadal artery, but the gonadal artery in this cadaver arrests from the renal, and this is the gonadal vein, left gonadal vein, which are drain into left renal. This is the left gonadal, which drain into the left renal. Right. Also, we see muscles in the posterior abdominal wall like this. This is the iliacus muscle. This is the psoas major muscle, psoas major, and this is the psoas minor muscle, psoas major, psoas minor, iliacus. This is the iliac crest, and this is the quadratus lumborum. Also, this is a nerve is present in the posterior wall, subcostal nerve, iliohypogastric, ilioinguinal, and this is a femoral nerve between psoas and iliacus. This is a femoral nerve. Also, in this side, we see this is iliacus muscle, and this is psoas major and psoas minor. In this side, this is the iliacus muscle, and this is the psoas major and psoas minor. Above the iliac crest, we see this is the quadratus lumborum muscle. Also, in this cadaver, this is the anterior abdominal wall, this is the external oblique. This is the opening in the external oblique superficial inguinal ring, and this is the spermatic cord, very clear spermatic cord, and this is the superficial inguinal ring, superficial inguinal ring. Plastic model showing the posterior abdominal wall and pelvis. In this model, we see this is the iliacus muscle, this is the iliacus muscle, and this is the psoas major and the psoas minor. And this is the quadratus lumborum, and this is the transversus abdominis. In this side, this is the iliacus muscle, this is the psoas major and the psoas minor, and this is the quadratus lumborum muscle. This is the posterior abdominal wall without organ. Also, posterior abdominal wall with kidney and spleen. This is the abdominal aorta. This is inferior vena cava, doing aorta divided into two common iliac, and this is a right, this is left kidney, and this is a right kidney, left subrenal gland, and this is the spleen. From the kidney, this is the ureter, and this is the gonadal vessels, gonadal artery from the abdominal aorta, and the gonadal vein. Also muscles present in the abdominal wall, this is the iliacus, this is the psoas major, iliacus psoas major, and this is the quadratus lumborum muscle. System in this plastic model, again, this is the abdominal aorta, inferior vena cava, and the two kidneys, right kidney and left kidney, and this is the right subrenal gland or left subrenal gland, and this is the renal vein, renal artery, and pelvis of the ureter, and this is the ureter. Ureter crossing the common iliac at its bifurcation to external and internal iliac. Ureter open in the urinary bladder. This is the urinary bladder. This is the apex of the urinary bladder, and the base of the urinary bladder from the whole posterior surface of the urinary bladder. This is a two seminal vesicle, and this is the termination of the vas deferens, ampulla of the vas deferens, and this is the prostate. Bladder from inside, like this. This is the bladder from inside. We open the bladder from inside to show this is a trigone. And this is the internal ureteral meatus, and this is the urethra. This is the trigone inside the urinary bladder. This is symphysis pubis in front, and this is the sacrum behind. This is the urinary bladder in male, and this is the rectum. In the urinary bladder, this is the apex of the bladder. From the apex, this ligament which reaches to the umbilicus, which is median umbilical ligament, and this is the bladder from inside, and this is the urethra. Urethra in male, this part, this called prostatic urethra, and this small part, which are membranous urethra, and this is the penile urethra inside the penis. This is a prostatic urethra and membranous urethra, and this is a penile urethra. Also in male, this is the vas deferens from the lateral side, vas deferens crossing the ureter here, and also the vas crossing this structure, which is external iliac artery and vein. Okay. Sagittal section in the female. This is the symphysis pubis in front, and this is the sacrum. The organs in the pelvis in the female in front, this is the urinary bladder, this is the uterus and the vagina, and most posterior in front of the sacrum, this is the rectum, continue as anal canal. This is the urinary bladder from inside, and this is the female urethra. Urinary bladder and the female urethra, and this is the uterus, fundus, the body, and cervix, and this is the vagina, and this is the rectum, continue as anal canal. From the uterus, and this is the fallopian tube, and this is the ovary, and this is the round ligament of the uterus. This is a human kidney. This is a kidney, and this is the suprarenal gland. This is the hilum of the kidney in front. This is the renal vein, and this is behind the renal artery. And most posterior, this is the ureter. Again, structure in the hilum, renal vein, renal artery, this is the ureter. So this kidney, this is a left kidney. This is superior and this is inferior, hilum medial, this is a lateral, and the structure in, from anterior and posterior, renal vein, renal artery, and the ureter most posterior. This is the left kidney. Plastic model in the lab. This is a plastic model for urinary system. This is abdominal aorta, and this is inferior vena cava. Abdominal aorta bifurcate into two, right common iliac and left common iliac. This is the right kidney, right suprarenal gland, left kidney, left suprarenal gland. Structure enters the hilum of the kidney from front backward, renal vein, renal artery, most posterior pelvis of the ureter. Then this is the ureter open in the urinary bladder. This is the posterior view showing the pelvis of the ureter is the most posterior structure. In this plastic model, we open the urinary bladder to show the trigone, which is a triangular area present in the base of the urinary bladder from inside. The trigone derived from endoderm, but the remaining mucous membrane of the bladder derived from mesoderm. Anterior relations of right and left kidney. This is the right kidney. The upper bowl or the upper part of the right kidney related to suprarenal gland. Then at the hilum related to the second part of the duodenum. Then this area related to the liver hepatic area. And the lower part of the lower bowl medially related to the jejunum, and the lateral related to the colic area, right colic flexure. Remember, from the medial 3S, suprarenal, second part of duodenum, small intestine. Anterior relation of the left kidney, the upper part related to 3S, medially suprarenal gland, intermediate gastric, and lateral spleen. The middle part of the in front of the left kidney related to the pancreas and the splenic artery. The lower part at the lower bowl medially related to the jejunum, laterally colic area related to the descending colon. Posterior relation of right and left kidney. This is the right kidney and this is the left kidney. The upper part of right and left kidney related to the diaphragm in green color. But in the right side, the diaphragm separates the kidney from the last rib only and the last intercostal space. But in the left side, the diaphragm separates the kidney from rib number 11 and rib number 12. Then the lower part of the kidney related to three muscles, right and left. Medially, this is related to the psoas major muscle, intermediate related to quadratus lumborum, most lateral related to transversus abdominis. Again, in this diagram, this is a posterior view
This is the right kidney and this is the left kidney related to the last rib and the last intercostal space, but this is red two ribs, rib number 11 and the number 12 and the last intercostal space. The lower part related to the three muscle, medially psoas major, intermediate quadratus lumborum, most lateral transversus abdominis. Posterior view of the plastic model again. This is a posterior surface. Why this is a posterior surface? Because this is the pelvis of the rotator most posterior structure. The upper part related to the diaphragm, right and left. This is the right side and this is the left side. But in the right side, diaphragm and last rib, we left side, diaphragm and the two ribs. And the three muscle, most medial psoas major, intermediate quadratus lumborum, most lateral transversus abdominis. This is the coronal section of the kidney. In the coronal section, this is the cortex of the kidney. This is the cortex outside. And this is pyramids. The tip of the pyramids is called renal papillae. Between two pyramids, there are what's called renal column. This is the renal column. Renal column. And this is the minor calyces, minor calyx. And this is the major calyces, and this is renal pelvis, which continue as ureter. Again, this is the coronal section in the kidney present in lab. This is cortex. And this is a pyramid, and this is the renal papillae. In between two pyramids, this is the renal column, and this is a minor calyces, which are collected into major calyces, and this is the pelvis of the ureter. Sagittal section in male, showing also lower part of the renal system. This is the urinary bladder. This is the apex of the renal bladder, which connected by ligament reach to the umbilicus called median umbilical ligament, which is obliterated urethrus. In front of the urinary bladder, this is the symphysis pubis. Most of the this is the sacrum. And behind the urinary bladder, this is the rectum, which continue as anal canal. At the neck of the renal bladder, this is the prostate, and this is the prostatic urethra, and this is small part membranous urethra, and this is the penile urethra present inside the penis. Also, in this view, this is the ureter which descend to open in the urinary bladder. This is a sagittal section in the female, showing organs in the pelvis. This is the renal bladder. Also, the apex of the renal bladder connected by ligament, which is median umbilical ligament connected to the umbilicus, which it was obliterated urethrus. The bladder continued downward by urethra. This is the urethra. This is the uterus, and this is the vagina. And this is the rectum, most posterior. In front of the pelvis, this is the symphysis pubis, and this is the sacrum. Also, in this plastic model, this is fallopian tube, and this is a ureter descend from above downward to open in the urinary bladder.